Let's say that I had the number 0.17. How could I say this number? I said it one way, I said 0.17, but what are other ways that I could say it, especially if I wanted to express it in terms of tenths or hundredths or other places? And like always, try to pause the video and try to think about it on your own. All right, so there's actually a couple of ways that we could say this number. One is just to say 0.17. Other ways are to say, look, I have a 1 in the tenths place, so that's going to be 1/10, 1/10, and 1/10, and I have a 7 in the hundredths place. So this is a 7 right over here in the hundredths place. So I could say 1/10 and 7/100. Hundredths. And there you go. That's one way to say this number. Now another way to think about it is just say the whole thing in terms of hundredths. So a tenth is how many hundredths? Well, a tenth is the same thing as 10/100. So you could say, instead of a tenth, you could say this is 10/100. And the way I'm writing it right now, very few people would actually do it this way. 10/100 and 7/100. And 7/100. Well, now I could just add these hundredths. If I have 10/100 and I have another 7/100, that's going to be 17/100. So I could just write this down as 17/100. Hundredths. And to make that intuition of how we could just call the 17/100 instead of just calling it 1/10 and 7/100, let's actually count by hundredths. So that is 1/100, that is 2/100, and actually let me just go straight to 9/100. So I've skipped a bunch right over here. And what would be the next, how would I say 10/100? Well, 10/100, let me write it this way, 10/100 is the same thing as 1/10. So if we go from 9/100, the next, if I'm counting by hundredths, the next one's going to be 10/100. Now, once again, 10/100 is the same thing as 1/10. Just the same way that 10/1 is the same thing as 1/10. I hope that doesn't confuse you. But we could keep counting. 10/100, 11/100, 12/100, 13/100, 14/100, 15/100, 16/100, and then finally 17/100. So hopefully that gives you a little intuition for why we can call this number, instead of just calling it 0.17 or 1/10 and 7/100, we could call this 17/100. So with that out of the way, let's do a couple of examples going the other way. Let's say we're given a name of a number, or the words, and we want to write it down as a decimal. So this is 4/10 and 3/100. All right, so 4/10. So the 4/10 right over here. So actually, let me just put some places over here. So this would be, if this is our tens place, and then this is our ones place, and then you're going to have your decimal, and then you're going to have your tenths place, and then you're going to have, and I'll do this in a different color, your hundredths place. Hundredths place. So we're going to have 4/10, not tenths, 4/10. So 4/10, 0/1, 0/1, we got our decimal. They don't have any tenths over here, so 0/10. And then we have 3/100, 3/100, so 3/100. So 4/10, which is the same thing as 40, and 3/100 right over here, so 40.03. Let's do another one of these. This is kind of fun. So we have 24/100. So by the logic that we saw in the first one, we could just write this as, remember, this would be 9/100, and if we went one more hundredth, this would be 10/100. So if we want to do 24/100, it would just be 0.24. And if you're saying, well, wait, this looks like 2/10 and 4/100, you'd be right. But remember, so actually I could rewrite this as 2/10 and 4/100. Let me say, and 4/100. But remember, a tenth is equal to 10/100. So 2/10 is the same thing as 20/100. Hundredths. I have trouble saying it. So this is the same thing as 20/100 and 4/100. And 4. Let me write it neatly. 4/100. And of course, 20/100 and 4/100 is the same thing as 24/100. So hopefully that makes sense.